Hello, good morning. That's my printer. Right, we are on Tuesday. I don't actually know what day it is. In fact, the calendar has not been moved from September. I know it's October because this is Vlogtober. I still have stuff to list. I didn't do enough yesterday. I have a quest which I need to do. I've gone in the shower and my hair's gone all big because I didn't wash it. Well, it's not big, is it? I mean, there's lots of people who have like big hair. Right, I have concluded that the reason that I'm wheezy is my own fault because this gaff is filthy. So it's all my fault. So I woke up in the night and I was very wheezy, which can only point to the fact that it's just thick with dust in every flipping room. So I am going to aim to take everything out of my bedroom. Our bedroom. Jason, he wakes up in the night and coughs as well. So I know it's us. I know it's the dirt. Yeah, so I just want to take everything out. And, you know, do light fittings. Although I have taken the Hoover around, I need to get like a feather dusted type situation and just go top to bottom. I'm going to empty my wardrobe, take everything that's off top of the wardrobe, try and get rid of all the shit that's under the bed because that's just caked with dust, and it's probably the stuff that sat under the bed which is affecting us. So that's what I'm going to do. But one of the things that I am going to do as well is I am going to go and buy some new curtains. I'm going to try and get some blackout curtains, which I think they have at B&M, so I'm going to go to B&M and see what they've got, because it says limited stock, which probably just means, you know, we've got one, because who knows if somebody was going to come in and buy blackout curtains. So I'm going to go and do that today, see what they've got, because the legacy in our bedroom is, and I realise that literally this month, because it was the 16th of October when we completed on this place, because I know that because the home insurance has gone out. You know, I'm not that wacko. It was probably actually the 14th, actually. So this is 6 years now that we've been here, and I know that we put up this temporary sheet because my husband worked nights, and he needed a blackout blind up, but we just put this sheet up as a blackout. And we quite like having a blackout anyway. He said I should buy thermal curtains. I'm not so sure. I think because the thing is that he will then say, I've got to put that sheet back up. And I am not putting that sheet back up so that we live like students. Because that's what I feel like. I mean, he's in his 50s, I'm in my 40s. And we've got this sheet up against with drawing pins in the wall like we're students. And it's ridiculous. So I'm going to go and sort that out today so that when I get round to doing this, which I'm hoping maybe Thursday, because I've got a lot on that. So I need to get that on and scheduled so that I like free myself up. And then I've got Lego, which I've started washing there. I need to get that sorted and sort of listed. So I'm going to try and do that as quickly as possible Tuesday, Wednesday, and then hopefully I can do this thing. But you know, I'm not confident that I can like take the curtains down and like wash them and dry them. Well, I won't be able to do that because it's now when, you know, it's autumn, winter. So that would just be a stupid idea. So that's what I'm going to do. This is sort of very long-winded. But then most of the stuff's going to come in here if I empty the bedroom, because you've got obviously, even if I didn't have an eBay business in the small bedroom, it's not all going to fit in the small bedroom. So, and I've got to sort through it. And I want to empty my wardrobe, and I want to clean my wardrobe, and then I want to make some like crazy decisions. So that's the quest. I've got to try and get myself organized with my eBay business in the next 2 days. Get some stuff listed, get some things sorted. And yeah. So I've only got three naff little things here. One of them's a bit of a revelation, actually. Who's written their phone number on the back of this? Oh, I hope that that's part of the thing and it isn't an actual phone number. Anyway, this is one of my Brothers Records, because they just slow, they're very slow sellers. But obviously it's I can't keep everything that he's got. That's one of the things which is under the bed, the records of his that I've decided to keep. So we'll be having to look at them. So it's not going to be like an easy thing. There's some sentimental shit under that bed. Right, anyway, Rufus, Shaka Khan, Shaka Khan, Shaka Khan. Everybody Shaka Khan. This is quite a nice gatefold, this is. Stomping at the Savoy. Yeah, so I've got £9 for that. I always send these records in these. So this is one of the reasons why I would like kind of like to like sell through them a bit quicker, because I've got all this stock of card stiffeners and these mailers, which have now gone onto one little shelf, but they weren't before and they were in the way. And then I have just like printed a load of these. I was saying, vinyl, do not bend. Because the trouble is, a lot of the post staff look at that and just assume that it's a calendar. Because obviously it's the same size as a standard calendar, because they all come that. That was my problem with some of these. I bought some cheaper ones of these and they were blatantly just calendar storage. So if you are selling records, be careful who you buy your record mailers off. Right, so anyway, that label is what was just doing its shaky thing over there. This sold on auction. Pretty green t-shirt, basic. I tend to find that I sell stuff out of season. This has been on auction throughout the summer, starting at that 9.99 bid with no interest. Great days. And then this next thing is something which I picked up before we even knew what COVID was. This has been in my shop for ages. Yeah, so at least 2 years, if not three. I don't even know when I started. I think this is probably one of these like tester items that I bought before I was even registered as a business, and I was probably still on a private account. So I bought this back in the day. Christ only knows how much I paid for this, probably a fiver. So this is weird, because this is, so yeah, 3 years. 3 years I've had this. So it's vintage Jaeger, made in Italy. Yeah, it's a small size, but it's a nice spacious size. It's only cotton. Yeah. So it was on auction for 4.99, and that has been a recurring auction, because all my auctions, I use the auto B list thing. So when my auctions end, it puts them into scheduled, like 2 or 3 or 5 days later, whenever I sort of like tier them so that I've got, so that because I use the 7 day auction, which is the free allowance, I then when it runs again, I want it to finish on a separate day. So it just goes into sort of like a bank of scheduled listings, and then it relists again. So it's been doing that for at least the summer. It's been doing that at 4.99, and then somebody last night sent me an offer, and I was like, whatever this offer is, I'm taking it. If they'd sent this offer at like £2, I would have accepted it, because it's been here that long. So they could have got it for £2 and I would have taken it, because this is just one of these things that I want gone. And their offer was £17, and I was like, yeah, well, how bad? I mean, it really, whatever they'd offered, I probably would have just taken it, because this, if the next time I did an analysis of all the stuff which I had in terms of like getting rid, that probably would have been got rid. So very pleased. It just goes to show, doesn't it? Sometimes just even the most random things just suddenly sell for more than you ever could have hoped. Very, very, very weird. So, what are we doing now? I've just realised my freaking mic isn't there. I should have realized that this mic was doing something stupid earlier. Yeah, it wasn't in. It did something earlier and then it flicked onto photo, and I should have realized that it disconnected itself. So, I'm a hopeless YouTuber. I know I say I'm a hopeless YouTuber, but I do have, I mean, I know you probably can't see it, but I do have some very nice failed mustache growth, very faint mustache growth, which technically should make me a very successful YouTuber, because I think that's the thing, is you have to have like crap moustache. Anyway, so I've been rambling on about my bedroom with no mic. So hopefully that came out. I probably need to like check now what's actually been recorded and what hasn't, because there's using an inferior mic and then there's using no mic. Right, anyway, let's carry on with the day. I'm going to take you to B&M. Oh, how exciting!
Thank you.
So I am going with these. The Oxford just seem like slightly better quality. I've not been stupid. I have measured the drop that I need. But these ones just feel a bit weird. And they're only singular, so I'd actually end up spending 50 quid if I bought two. I think this is two in here. It says plural curtains. Curtains. Sorry, that's a joke. I keep hearing people saying curtains. And it says the thermal. So I'm going to go with these. And I know there's loads of choice. And I know that black is probably a bit weird, but I want my blackouts to be black. And we're goth anyway, so it doesn't matter. There's these though, isn't there? Ooh, grey. No, I don't think I'll ever be a grey person.
Hello, Simon Frog here. Oh, okay. You're coming in.
I am coming in. So, it's gone 5 o'clock. I should really show you what I got at the old B&M. It's a B&M. I went in there specifically for what I needed, so I only picked these up because they've got the free ticket on, as in this voucher. So I think they were like £2 or something rather. So I'll get my money back on them by selling them on eBay, because there's not many of them around. And then look at this. So this was £9.99. Well, there's flipping two of them. And I can't find the purple topped one, the Colour Protect ones these days. I don't know what's going on. Probably because they've got a new formula, haven't they? I don't know. Anyway, that's brilliant for me. Not that I really want like two bottles in the cupboard, but there you go. And then the blackout curtains that I actually did get. So it does look like there is two of them. Now I've got no excuse. So I've got to do this cleaning. It seems that the drop is okay. They're going to be quite long, but it doesn't matter. Warm in the winter, cool in the summer. Reduces noise levels. We will see. It's very noisy around here. People like to talk in the street in the middle of the night, and we also get lots of people who like drive around with music blaring from bicycles and random things. So yeah, I'm quite happy with them. I think they'll be fine. I know that I could just like take the curtains down and wash them and, you know, put them back up, but it would end up, it's going to be raining by the end of the week by the time I actually get round to doing this. You know, and it's going to cause carnage. I want to do it all in one day, and we do need curtains up. And I do think we did need these curtains because we've been this student. Because we've got this sheet up, it's just annoying me. I don't. My husband seems to think that it's like there's nothing wrong with having a sheet up instead of a thingy, but it's, and his excuse is that it's a blackout curtain. So this is a blackout curtain, and it's also supposed to be a thermal curtain. And all these other things. So for £40, that's fine by me. You know, I think that it's a healthy investment. So I have done some listing, and I've mainly done cleaning of sorting of Lego. So I've done all my sorting of my Lego, and I've got to try and work out what sets they are, because I need to get as much of this done and off the floor, because I'm aiming to clean on Thursday and I want to empty the entire bedroom, so I need to get as much on as possible. And although I have listed some clothing, they're still there, and I haven't even sorted through my paperwork yet, and I really need to do that because there's just like papers everywhere. And my biggest problem at the moment is this coffee table, which is disgusting. But anyway, that will be for tomorrow's vlog, you know. And I will show you how disgusting this coffee table is, because it's just ridiculous. It's like every time we have like a medical niggle, the whatever tablet it is that we've taken stays on the coffee table, and now we've got loads of them. So I'm going to carry on listing. Am I going to carry on listing? Yeah, I'm going to carry on listing, because I'm kind of there with it. you know what? I'm not going to carry on listing. I'm actually going to do the Lego, because to be honest, if there's a pile of clothes there and I still haven't listed all those clothes, that's not so bad for me emptying the room out. But having Lego here is going to be a problem because I'm going to end up flicking it everywhere. So I'm going to carry on with my Lego. There will be a Lego video coming up. I know that a lot of you don't like... a lot of you don't watch them, but I make more money off my Lego and it's more consistent immediate sales than I ever make off my clothing. Clothing is, you know, although it's like simple when it comes to packing it up, the Lego sells very easily and obviously it's Christmas. So anyway, I am going to go. Thank you for watching and I will be back again soon with more Vlogtober.
And it'll be dinner time soon. Yeah. Yeah, thanks for watching. Subscribe, you busters. And thank you for everybody who has described. Described, subscribed and described. I love you.
Steady.
I'm not looking forward to this cleaning thing because I know what's going to happen. We're all going to end up being put in the washing machine if it's really clean in the bedroom. Always being bathed.